guys, what's up? Welcome back to our channel. I'm finally back to making content on YouTube. Our brand has launched, our website is live, and it feels so surreal when I say this, but I'm actually wearing a sweatshirt from our brand, House of Sharom. It is crazy, guys. It is so unbelievable that we have a brand, but it's actually true and it is such a beautiful feeling. If you do want to check out our brand and our range, I'm going to leave a link in the pinned comment of the comment section below. You can check it out there. Apart from that, you can also check out the video which we made about our brand announcement. You'll find a lot of details there. It was a video before this one, like just the previous video, so you can check that out as well. Now let's talk about today's video. So in today's video, I am actually going to show you my updated face grooming routine. So this is something which I do on a weekly basis, and there's one thing which I do once a month, which is face shaving. I'm shooting this video in daylight, so there is a possibility that the light might fluctuate. Please bear with me if that happens. Lastly, the links of all the products will be mentioned in the description box below. You can check them out. None of this is sponsored. This is my very raw and real face grooming routine. Now without further ado, let's begin. I hope the light is not too bright and you can see me clearly. Sometimes I really wish I could ask you if the lighting is okay. Unfortunately, I can't, but I'm seeing in the viewfinder, I think the lighting is okay. Now, the first thing which I do when I begin my face grooming routine is plucking my eyebrows. So I do get my eyebrows done in a parlor once a month, and then I just pluck out the extras. I do have an eyebrow plucker. This is from Vega. It's a good plucker. It's a pretty good plucker. I just pluck out the extras from this area. Like, I don't touch this area much or the top much because, you know, I don't want to end up plucking out a lot of hair. In short, I just pluck out my extra growth from my brow bone. I don't have too many of them. Like, usually the hair on my face grow very slowly. So I am just going to show you a little bit of what I do. Okay, I'm so sorry guys, I really don't have too many hair to pluck. Like, I do this every week, right? I did this last week, so not too much of growth has come out. Every week, once I pluck out all the extras, and it keeps my eyebrows neat and clean. Now, the next thing which I do again once a week is my upper lips. Now, for my upper lips, I actually have this little thing from Braun. Since the time I've gotten this, I have actually not gotten my upper lips done in a parlor. It is very efficient. This is how the machine looks like, guys. It is battery operated. I bought it 2 months ago. I have not changed the battery yet. It is still working properly. Top of the machine that you see over here, this rotates, okay, and it rotates pretty fast. And you can change the direction of the rotation with this button itself. I'll switch it on and show you. So you can see this head is rotating and it kind of plucks out the hair from your face, from your upper lips. I'm going to make a lot of funny faces right now, so please bear with me. My upper lips are completely clean. Please don't press the machine too hard on your upper lips, okay? You have to just like lightly touch it to your skin and it will do its job. I really like this product. It has made my life so much easier, guys. It's not even funny. Now moving on to face shaving. I personally shave my face once a month. As I told you earlier, I don't get a lot of growth on my face, so once a month is more than enough for me. If you have heavy growth, then you can do it once a week, but I would not recommend doing it more than once a week, because when you use a razor on your face, it also exfoliates your face, and over exfoliation is really not good for your skin. These are the two razors which I use for shaving. There's a big one and there's a small one. I'll tell you why I have two different razors. First thing that I do before shaving my face is secure my hair. You have to be very careful when you're using razors on your face, guys. It is so easy to shave off your sideburns or your eyebrows or your baby hair, you know. Please do not do that. It does not give a good look. I use an aloe vera gel to shave my face. I made a face shaving video about 2 years ago, and at that point of time, I used to use a mix of aloe vera gel with tea tree oil. But now, this is the gel which I use for face shaving. It is from Sadhev. It is their aloe vera and saffron gel. Yeah, sorry about this, guys. Really sorry about that. and I have almost finished this. Since I do face shaving once a month, it lasts me a long time. I think I've had this tub for about 4 months now. This is actually a really impressive product, guys. I really like the feel of the product on my skin. It just, you know, hydrates the skin, nourishes the skin. After I tried it out, I actually started sending my mom as well this aloe vera gel, and sometimes you get like great discounts on it. MRP is pretty high, but I try and buy it whenever there is a discount running on this product. Now let's start shaving. I'm going to scoop out a bit of aloe vera gel. This razor is washed and sanitized, by the way. Always wash and sanitize your razors before using them and after using them. So I am going to apply a bit of aloe vera gel on one side of my cheek. Not just my cheek, actually one side of my face, because I ended up taking a little extra aloe vera gel. The good thing is that this gel is also going to stick my sideburns on my face so that I know that I don't have to shave them off. Now, I'm going to take this razor and slowly start shaving my face. Never do it in the opposite direction of your growth. Always do it downwards, okay? I've kept a tissue paper handy so that I can clean my razor on it. Take your time and be very slow with this process, guys. Razors are pretty sharp, so be super careful when you're using razors. Use it with a very light hand. I'm going to repeat the same process on the other side of my face. I'm going to apply a generous amount of aloe vera gel. Stick my sideburns with it so that I don't shave them out. And start shaving in the downward direction. The face is more or less done. Now I'm going to shave my T-zone, okay? And for that, I'll use this small razor. Now, I don't get any hair on my nose, but because face shaving exfoliates the face, I run the razor once on my nose as well. Going to apply a bit of aloe vera gel on this area and start shaving it. This razor is actually very good for areas which are a little difficult to reach, or the areas where you feel that you'll accidentally shave off something that you don't want to shave off. Next, I'm going to take a little bit of aloe vera gel again. I'm going to leave this on for at least 15 to 20 minutes and then I'm going to wash it off. Why I wash it off is because I do apply something else as well to nourish my skin. But if you want, you can of course leave it on for a longer time, or you can just sleep with it. Also, I do feel like a little bit of a burning sensation after shaving, especially after shaving when I apply the aloe vera gel. I can feel a little bit of tingling and burning, but in my case, it is absolutely normal. It just happens because shaving is a rigorous form of exfoliation, so it can happen. I'm going to leave this on for 15 to 20 minutes, wash my face, and then come back. I wash my face, it is all clean and fresh and nice. I washed it with warm water. You can also wash it with normal water. Warm water just feels really nice on the skin. I completely forgot to show you one more thing which I do after doing my upper lips and before shaving. I can't show you the demo for it because my heart won't agree to do this on camera. It's trimming my nostril hair, guys. I do trim the hair in my nostrils. I don't want to gross you out or anything. I trim my hair with this particular trimmer. This is from Philips. I like to keep the area clean. You don't have to like completely trim out all your nostril hair, because there's a purpose of those hairs. They are there to protect your nose. I do trim them a little bit. I'm not going to show this in front of the camera, but I've switched the machine on. I, you know, put it inside my nostril and I rotate it like this. After trimming your nostril hair, you just have to wash this little head under running water and you'll be done. And wash your nose a little bit as well. Like, you'll have to clean your nose with a tissue and stuff. Now we've come to the last and final step, which is applying a cream. I like to shave my face during the night because, you know, the skin is a little raw after shaving your face and it needs a bit of time to settle down. And nighttime is when your skin repairs itself, so it's the best time to apply a lot of creams on your skin, look like a greased chicken, and then go off to bed. The cream which I use after shaving my face is from Bioderma. It's called Atoderm Intensive Balm. This is such a good cream for dry skin, guys. This cream repairs the barrier of your skin. So it feels really good on my dry skin, guys. Especially after shaving, when my skin is all raw, it really calms it down. It gives it a lot of nourishment. And the next day when I wake up, my skin feels really soft. The consistency of this cream is very thick. You definitely cannot apply it during the day. And a little goes a long way. You don't have to use too much of it. After making these little dots on my face, I'm going to massage my skin with this cream. That's it, guys. My face is not looking all that greasy, but it is quite sticky right now. This is a night cream for sure. You can't use it during the day. This was pretty much my entire face grooming routine, guys. There's nothing more that I do apart from this. When I started face shaving, I actually did it without applying anything on my skin. I shaved my face dry and that gave me a lot of bumps. After that, I started using aloe vera gel and it works like a charm. If you don't want to buy this aloe vera gel, you can just buy any normal aloe vera gel. Mix maybe a drop of tea tree essential oil. That will also work well for you. Or you can buy the Sadhev aloe vera and saffron gel. You don't need to mix anything in it. It's really good. Anyway, guys, with that, we've come to an end of this video. Please consider subscribing to our channels. We've got this channel where I post beauty content and we've got another channel where we post vlogs. Apart from that, please check out our brand's Instagram handle and our brand's website. We definitely want more and more people to know about our brand. We worked really hard on it. It's an honest, ethical brand. So please check it out. It would mean a lot to us. And please spread the word if you can. That would mean a lot to us as well. You can also consider following me on Instagram. I post video updates and some makeup related content here and there on my Instagram handle. There's no pressure at all. Only if you like what you see, only then consider following and subscribing. And on that note, I'm going to sign off for now. Please take care of yourself and stay safe. I love you. Thank you so much for all your love and support. I'm so, so grateful. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. Mwah.